Hey everybody, welcome back to Conan Exiles. I'm Rotten John, and today I just wanted to give you a quick look at the seven different religions you can pick during the character customization screen. So there are seven different religions you can choose from, and we're going to take a general look at which ones you can pick and what each one has to offer for you. So during the character customization screen, you can go male, you can pick a female, it doesn't matter, whichever you prefer. You can pick your races, your voices, your facial and body customizations, and you can also pick your religions. And we're going to take a look at the religions and what each one basically has to offer you on your way through your journey. And a little bonus tip here that many of you may not know, you can change your in-game name on this screen here. You can go back and redo your character, you can edit your character, you can confirm it if you like the way it is, but if you want to change your in-game name, all you simply do is click on your name up at the top here, erase that, backspace, or just type over it, and this is where you can add your new name onto your character, which will show up in-game anytime anybody approaches you or is near you. This is the name that other players will see above your character. Alright, cool beans, you know how to change your in-game name now. Now let's jump in and take a look at what the religions have to offer you so you have a better idea of which one you might want to pick during character creation. So first up here, we're going to start with the Mitra religion. And here we have one of our Mitrian altars. There are three different levels to your altars. You have your basic altar, your intermediate one, and your final best altar you can make for each religion. And you'll also have some type of weapon you can use to get the offerings of whatever religion it is that you've chosen, which will help you upgrade your altar or, at the final stages, make the god. You also get some form of armor with each religion, or maybe weapons. This is the Mitrian armor. It is a lightweight armor that comes with bonus grit while you're wearing it, which means it gives you bonus points to your grit attribute. But for the sake of this video, we're not going to get into the exact numbers of armors or weapons. I just want to give you a quick overview of what each religion has to offer and maybe give you a little better understanding of which religion you want to choose during character creation. So here we are in our little make-believe world, and we've already made our true name of Mitra. We're going to summon the gods so I can give you a quick look at what each god for each religion looks like and maybe what it does during its attacks. And here we have the god of Mitra. You do control your gods just the same way you control your character, forward, backwards, left, right, and your action key or button is your attack button with the god. And keep in mind that gods can be killed by other players. It's pretty rough, pretty hard for them, but it can be done. Now, a lot of servers have their god's lifespan set to 2 minutes. I have it set to 1 minute, just to kind of keep this video a little bit shorter. Alright, well that was fun. Now let's take a look at my personal favorite religion, the Set religion. Alright, now with our Set religion, you're going to see that we also have the three different tiers of the Set altars. You'll have that in all of your religions. But in Set, we get these kind of cool snake arrows. They do stack poison on your enemies. And we also get a nice Set antidote, which will help if you get hit by a scorpion or a reaper and they stack poison on you. You can slam down one of these potions and get rid of the poison fairly quickly. Never mind the bow in there, that's just a regular hunting bow that you can make at an early level on your own. I just have it just so I can give you a quick look at what the poison snake arrows do. I'll show you how well they work against the scorpion here. As you can see, when we shoot the scorpion, it does start to stack poison on the scorpion. You can stack up to 10 poison at a time, and this scorpion is already going to be dead before he even knows it. Alright, a quick look at the armor that you can get from having the Set religion. This is the Setite armor. It comes with the Set religion. It is a light grade armor that gives you bonus accuracy, which would be great for a bow build. And the mask on this armor is also really good to have. You can get it at an earlier stage than you can get your sandstorm mask. And we're going to take it from our little dancer here, and I'm going to show you how well it works in the Shattered Springs area, which is full of the poisonous gas. All right, here we are up at the Shattered Springs, and as some of you know, it is full of poisonous gas. You need a sandstorm mask or this set mask to be able to survive inside of here. If I take the mask off, you'll see that I start taking damage from the poisonous gas in this area. I'm going to throw it back on so I don't die and can continue making the video for you. Oh, and then we get hit by one of the new rock nose beasts. So we're going to hurry up, get out of here, go back, and get back on with the video. Alright, we got through that okay. Now let's use our name of Set from our Set altar and conjure up the Set God. Our Set God is a giant snake, and you control it just like you do with the last god and or your character while in game. Alright, on to our Dark Keto religion. She is the goddess of love and death, to put it simply. Alright, inside of this Dark Keto altar, we get some nice looking armor here that, well, doesn't really look so good on a male, but it is a lightweight armor and does give you bonus agility points to your attributes. But it can be mixed and matched with other armors to make up some pretty cool looking armor. This religion also comes with transmute honey, transmute meat, and a few other things that we'll get into in another video. But yeah, let's get to the fun part and summon the god now for this religion. Alright, pretty terrifying god there. Now let's take a look at our Yogg religion. Alright, nothing real super special with the basic Yogg religion altar. Remember though, you can advance it up to the top level altar. And here's a quick look at our Yogite armor set. It is a lightweight armor that does give bonus survival points to your attributes. Now let's have a little fun with this religion and summon the Yogg god. Alright, let's take a quick look at the Ymir religion now. Inside of our Ymir religion altar, you can see that we can make ice, we can make a hoarfrost hatchet, we can make ice shard arrows, which are a little better than what you can make out in the open world, and we also have a Ymir armor that we can make. Here's a quick look at our Ymir armor on our oh-so-happy-to-show-you dancer here, and once we go into the armor, you will see that it is a heavy armor, and does give bonus strength points to your attributes while you're wearing it. Now let's go summon our Ymir god and take a look to see what it looks like. Just in case you haven't realized it, the Ymir god is heavily tied into the Frost Giant area up north. Now I'm going to speed the video up to 2x just so we can get through this a little bit quicker. Now we come to our Krom religion, and Krom actually has nothing to show you, so we're going to move on to the newest religion, the Zath religion. Yeah, that's right, Zath, the spider god. Zath comes with his little dagger that you use to harvest the enemies and gain your essence of Zath so you can upgrade your altars or summon your god later on. He also comes with a unique armor set and these pretty cool globes here that you can throw and have spiders come out of them. This is a quick look at the Zath armor set, another one I probably wouldn't wear on a male character. If you tried to walk outside like this, your friends might beat you up, I don't know. Anyways, it is a light armor. It does give you bonus vitality points to your attributes, which equate to more health. These also are the orbs that you can toss around at your enemies, maybe even throw them in your friend's base if you want. I believe these have been nerfed so that you can only have one or two spiders running around fighting at a time now. It used to be you could just spam the living crap out of these and have spiders everywhere when they first come out with the Zath religion. So yeah, let's jump ahead and take a look at the new Zath god. And for those of you that have arachnophobia, you know, the fear of spiders, this may not be the god for you, because let me tell you, there's a lot of spiders here. And here is our big guy, the Zath god. Now you control this guy just like you would another god or your character, and god, I'd love to ride around on a big giant spider. But anyways, I don't know if you can see it on your screen, however when you do your attack, you do get this kind of bubble aim assist that shows you roughly where your attack is going to land. And Zath here shoots these flaming, kind of like sticky web ball kind of things. This might be something else fun to shoot over into your neighbor's base every now and then. I don't know. Tell your friend or your neighbor that I told you to shoot the Zath flaming balls into their base. God damn, it'd be great to tame one of these things and ride around the map on it. Alright guys, so that's the end of the religions. I hope you found it interesting. Remember, you can always go around and find all of the trainers and learn all of the religions, or you can use your feat points to buy the religions as you want. I'll put a card up here to show you the video where to find all of the religions. I hope you guys have a great day, and we'll see you next time.